Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be learning about something called the reproductive system. Okay, so actually today we are not going to learn everything in full. We are going to learn the grade 5 version, and in the grade 5 version we go pretty small in the grade 5 version, meaning we don't learn everything by heart. Okay, so and we only learn a few things, and all the rest is we'll learn in the higher grades, 6th and 7th. So let's go to the next slide. Let's go to the next slide. Okay. So now we must. Now, here we must figure out what is puberty. Okay. So in the reproductive system, puberty is a very important part. Puberty is the process of physical changes through which a child's body matures into an adult body capable of sexual reproduction. Okay, though, so don't think sexual reproduction is an offensive word. Sex actually means gender, and sexual reproduction, well, we'll learn it in few minutes. So in puberty, the child sees growth in different parts. Like some people get mustache, the boys get mustaches, and girls like hair starts growing all over the body. Boys' puberty starts at around 10 years and ends at 17, and girls start at around 12. And ends at 17 also. Okay, so now we will need to learn what is sexual reproduction. Okay, so sexual reproduction is after puberty. The male produces hundreds of sperms, and female produces an egg inside the body. Male has sperms inside the body. The sperm needs to reach the egg to make it fit for birth or purify it. Fit for birth literally means, fit for birth literally means purify. Okay? Fit for birth meaning purify, and this process is called sexual reproduction. And here's a note: only one sperm can purify the egg, and the rest of the hundreds of sperms go to waste. And also, guys, I request you to listen to this very carefully, because in my next video, which I will probably make in some time, is gonna take me time a bit. I'm going to put a quiz on this. Okay? And if you want to answer it, you better pay attention to this video and share it with your friends so they can have the quiz. And this quiz, I will reveal the answers in the next video of the quiz, my next video, and also the winner of the quiz, this quiz contest will be announced, and you can tell me the answers by emailing me at my email ID abhyuday.jha@gmail.com. Please put the subject quiz on sexual reproduction. Okay. Okay, so let's get back to the topic. Now we must see the female reproductive parts. This is the female reproductive parts. So this smooth muscle will not be in the fifth grade topic, okay? And in this diagram, the old in this diagram, there are many things to remember, but don't worry, maybe you can make it easier, because for fifth grade it's only like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 organs. So let me explain to you. You see this tube over here? This tube is known as the fallopian tube, and this small circle here is the ovary. See, in the ovary, the egg is formed and stored. Then the egg goes through the fallopian tube, and the sperm will be when and when if the sperm is coming up the fallopian tube, if sexual reproduction happens at the right time, then the sperm will come through the fallopian tube, and the egg and the sperm will meet, making a purified egg. Now, where are we going to keep this egg until it's ready to come out of the body? The pregnancy time usually takes 3 whole months. So where are we going to keep this? Well, that's where the uterus gets to work. Uterus is also known as the womb, and the egg is stored in here. And since the egg is big, that part becomes bigger. So now you guys know that pregnancy doesn't happen in the stomach. Then after the time is over, it goes down the cervix. This small pipe is the cervix, and then the egg exits as an offspring in the vagina. Okay, so these are the female parts. Now let's look at the male. Male, now we do not need to learn about all of these complex topics. I simply did not have the time to remove them, but I will just remove the ones we don't have to learn. Vas deferens, no. Prostate, no. Semial vesicle, no. Bladder is also no. We don't have uttera, and we also don't have epididymis. The only things we are going to have in the grade 5 syllabus is the testicle and penis. So when the sperm bo is born, it's born in the testicle, and it travels up this pipe and goes down here into the penis. So this pipe is actually a part of the testicle, and in the penis, in this tube, the sperm goes out into the female body. Okay, so this is the reproductive system, and we are soon going. And I know many of you will have the question: what if the egg is not purified? What if the egg is not purified? What will happen to the egg? Well, I will answer the question in one of my future videos. So make sure you are subscribed. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching my video. I will look forward for you to subscribe and watch more of my videos. Also, remember to share this with your friends. Hit the like button, and mostly please do not forget to subscribe. It helps me a lot. So thank you, everybody. See you later.